Hi there, welcome to today's life series. We have been looking at the fruit of the Spirit and the different facets of the fruit of the Spirit. Today I'm going to take us through the fruit of the Spirit, the facet of self-control. My name is Wangashi Mwaneke, stick around. Now, the fruit of the Spirit is one. Unlike many people who say the fruits of the Spirit, the fruit of the Spirit is one, but with different facets that all join together. And we are going to be looking at self-control. So, I want us to read John chapter 15, verse 4 to 5. I'm going to read it in the, I think, NIV version. Abide in me, and I in you, as the branch cannot bear fruit by itself, unless it abides in the vine. Neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever abides in me and I in him, it is that bears much fruit. For apart from me, you can do nothing. Galatians chapter 5, verse 22. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such things there is no law. We cannot bear the fruit of the Spirit unless we abide in Christ and he abides in us. John 15 from 4 to 5 is showing us that when we say yes to Jesus, he comes into our hearts through the power of the Holy Spirit, and he dwells there. And when we dwell more in him and we yield more to him, then we're able to bear the fruit of the Spirit wholesomely. The fruit of the Spirit, as I said in the beginning, has many facets: love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness. But all are so intertwined, because until you genuinely love, until you're able to genuinely be patient and kind and good, then you won't be able to have self-control. So they all link together. Walking in the Spirit is like exercising a muscle. Let me give an example. I swim sometimes. Okay, I try to swim a lot. When I've not swum in a long, long time, when I go back to the water, my breath becomes, I get tired more quickly. I lose my breath more quickly. I become slower. My time becomes really bad. I can do few laps. But the more I train and the more I go back to water, more and more times, what happens is after a while, my speed gets fast. I am able to control my breathing better. I'm able to take more laps. I'm able to be even faster and do better record time. That's the same thing like walking in the Spirit. When you exercise the act of walking in the Spirit more, it becomes easier to do as the Spirit says. It becomes easier to bear fruit. It becomes easier because you've been doing it over and over and over and over again. So what's the solution for us to have the fruit of the Spirit? What's the solution for us to have self-control, all these facets of the Spirit, joy, love, patience? It's simple: abiding in Christ, him abiding in us, and just walking with the Spirit. It is one Spirit, one fruit, with different facets. It includes having self-control, includes learning how to be moderate, learning how to be restraining, learning how to be thoughtful. Romans 12 verse 2 tells us that do not conform to the patterns of the world, but rather be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And until we are able to understand what that means, then we are able to walk in the Spirit, abide in Christ, and be different. Now, one of the ways that you can tell someone has really been walking with the Spirit and one of the facets he has is self-control is when this person is able to say, no, I won't do that. When this person is able to develop assertiveness, when this person is able to learn how to not be gluttonous, to learn how to be patient with people, to learn how to restrain from all forms of ungodliness, because the Spirit of God is able to teach us to say no to all forms of ungodliness, then grow the muscle of self-control. So how do you exercise this muscle? How do you exercise this muscle of self-control, this facet of the fruit of the Spirit? How do you become better at self-control, at love, at patience, at kindness, at goodness? I'm going to give you four things that I think are very important. Then we shall call it a wrap. So Number one, do not neglect the coming together of saints. When we come together as believers, we're able to encourage one another to keep walking in the Spirit, and then we're able to bear fruit. Pray, 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 pray. And again I say, pray. Study God's word. God's word is able to renew our minds and transform us into actually wanting to do what God wants us to do. Then finally, surround yourself with intentional Christians. Be intentional about surrounding yourself with intentional Christians who are living out the walk of faith, who are exercising the different facets of the fruit of the Spirit, who are intentional about love and kindness and patience and self-control, which is very, very important in this day and age. Then the result is we'll have people who are not gluttonous. We'll have Christians who wait until marriage to have sex because they have the facet of self-control. We'll have Christians who do not get angry and beat people up, but show kindness and show patience. We'll have Christians who are self-controlled, have the full spirit, have the full fruit of the Spirit, and are walking daily to be more and more like Jesus. Thank you for joining me on this live series. See you next time. Until then, Baraka.